Infinity. And by Bud Light.
Welcome back. And we're getting set now for our second national semifinal. Making their 16th Final Four appearance and third in 4 years, winners of the Midwest Regional, please welcome the Kentucky Wildcats. Aaron Harrison hits the three.
Come on, Wildcats, I can't hear you.
Get low. Harrison lobs it for Young.
How about that move by Julius Randle?
Come on, Wildcats, let's go.
Harrison. No, he made it. The kids from Kentucky have banded together.
We are Kentucky.
Let's go, Cats.
Starting tonight for the Kentucky Wildcats. At forward, a freshman from Rochester Hills, Michigan. Number one, James Young. At guard, a freshman from Richmond, Texas. Number two, Aaron Harrison. At guard, a freshman from Richmond, Texas. Number five, Andrew Harrison. At forward, a freshman from Dallas, Texas. Number 30, Julius Randle. And at center, a freshman from Brooklyn, New York, number 44, Dakari Johnson. And now, appearing in the Final Four, for the first time since 2000, from the Big Ten, the winners of the West Regional, please welcome the Wisconsin Badgers.
Let's go, get loud, let's go. Come on, Badger fans, stand up.
The answer, it's Gosser. Kaminsky, got it. Oh, big finish for three. Yes. Wisconsin is headed for the Final Four.
We are Wisconsin.
Go Badgers.
Starting tonight for the Wisconsin Badgers. At guard, a senior from Hawthorne Woods, Illinois. Number one, Ben Brust. At guard, a junior from Westerville, Ohio. Number 12, Trayvon Jackson. At forward, a sophomore from Sheboygan, Wisconsin. Number 15, Sam Decker. At guard, a junior from Port Washington, Wisconsin. Number 21, Josh Gosser. At forward, a junior from Lisle, Illinois. Number 44, Frank Kaminsky. And introducing the head coaches for Kentucky in his fifth season for the Wildcats, John Calipari. For Wisconsin in his 13th season for the Badgers, Bo Ryan. Well, we've met the Badgers and the Wildcats, and we're about to find out who will be UConn's opponent on Monday night. On the floor, there is Cauley Stein, who got injured in that Sweet 16 thriller against Louisville. And the officials for the second national semifinal, Mike Stewart, Pat Adams, Terry Weimer, and again, Mike Roberts, is the standby official at the table. Kaminsky and Randle. Ready for the opening tap.
Oh,
This should be a whole lot of fun as Wisconsin and Kaminsky take the tap.
And really want to take a look at this matchup of Decker and Randall. Really, Decker's more of a small forward. Randall, obviously, a power player. Let's see how this matchup starts to evolve, Steve, for both teams.
And what I'm looking for, Greg, is the patience of Kentucky's defense. As Jackson lines up a three and misses. When you play Wisconsin, you have to defend the entire clock. They're not going to turn it over. They're not going to be bothered by your pressure. So Kentucky has to maintain patience defensively in order to get into a good groove in this game.
Nearly stolen, but Kentucky has the numbers. Randall misses the shot. On the floor, gets it back. Out to Young, and he hits the three.
Biggest difference, and you guys have seen every Kentucky game in the tournament. To me, the biggest difference since the regular season is just their three-point percentage. I mean, they're over 40% now for the tournament, up 32% on the regular year. So they're getting better looks, and they're knocking them down.
Driving in and reverse for two. Gosser.
And that's a great point, but it's also because the shot selection for Kentucky has improved. And Gosser's a guy who's getting his athleticism back. He's dealt with the knee injuries. You could see it on that drive. Far more explosive with his attack.
That was a big basket for Gosser, too. He was 1-for-10 in the regional last week, and he needed something to go early to build his confidence.
And that's the span over the two games out there in Anaheim, and the Badgers able to come up with it is Andrew Harrison a little out of control. Jackson jumper, not this time. He's 0-for-2 from the outside. And Harrison looking for somebody to throw it to. No one there except Gosser.
And Harrison, both Andrew and Aaron are used to having a size and strength advantage at the guard position, and they're able to get the angle when they attack the rim. Jackson and then also Gosser a little bit stronger with their perimeter D.
There they are, brother to brother for two. Andrew with the steal and the assist, and Aaron converts the shot.
Rare turnover for Wisconsin. Bo Ryan's team, number one club in the nation in terms of fewest turnovers, just 8 per game. I think both teams may be a little jittery here early, as you would expect.
Russ on the floor was tripped while he was trying to make the cut. Decker. And here's Jackson for yet another shot. This time he's got it.
And the confidence in Jackson. Missed his first two, which probably weren't great shots, but the third one in rhythm from Decker from beyond.
Harrison comes out of the lane. Now Young slashing. And he'll be shooting a couple of free throws. Get your team your way with the Final Four TeamCast. That means you can watch the Kentucky TeamCast on TNT right now and the Wisconsin TeamCast on True TV.
And that possession right there, Ben Russ, they cross-matched. They're going to have him guard James Young. You have to realize that he is a left-hand dominant driver. And you have to sit on his left hand if you're Bruss on that closeout there. Not a good job defensively.
Poitras comes in for Kentucky, and Bruss did get called for the foul.
Greg, I think what we just saw in that sequence is the key to this whole game for Wisconsin. Their ability to contain penetration, because if Kentucky breaks them down, even if they miss the shot, as you showed in the open, now they're going to crash the glass. So Wisconsin has to stay in front, play those gaps.
Haven't had much action from Kaminsky at this end of the floor to this point. And he throws it out of bounds.
Really a good job there on the double team by Kentucky. And what they did, they waited till he put the ball down. Much more difficult for a big guy to play out of a double team once you use that live dribble. Really good decision there by Kentucky.
They're going to bring in Nigel Hayes and Bronson Koenig. And they're going to actually sit down for a moment, Brust and Kaminsky.
Very small lineup for Wisconsin. I think we have a clock issue here the officials will take care of. But look at Wisconsin now. Hayes is basically the center. And Decker, who, as you mentioned, Greg, is more of a small forward, stays at that power forward spot on Randle, but without Kaminsky's protection at the rim. If I'm Kentucky, I'm trying to get the ball to Randle on this possession to go at Decker.
Randle away from the basket. Now he's got Nigel Hayes on him. Young's got the three. Tapped out to Jackson. And he had a tap from behind. What a nice play by Jackson. Tapped it to his teammate, and Koenig scores.
A bad decision there, I thought, by Young. You had a mismatch. Actually, they put Decker on that possession on Dakari Johnson. They didn't recognize it there, and that leads to a transition opportunity for the Badgers.
Here's Young, cradling it and scoring off the glass.
I'm not sure Wisconsin's gotten the memo yet, but you know, James Young is left-handed.
He's
he is going to drive yeah. to his left.
Yeah, spoken by a left-hander.
Yeah.
He's got seven of their nine. It's Decker working on Randle. Draws the whistle. Got the under 16 timeout. And that foul was on Dakari. Nice heads-up play, though. The only play he had by Trayvon Jackson was to tap it to his teammate. But it's James Young. He's been slashing and scoring here at the start. Kentucky up a bucket at the first break. The third ever national champion was Wisconsin 41. Kaminsky's gonna stay on the bench here. And it's Decker at the line for two.
Decker also, Jim, last weekend did not score the ball, did not shoot well. And so I like what he did on that last possession. He attacked off the spin move. He was settling for fadeaway jumpers in the last couple of games of the tournament. And he's so talented. He's so quick. He needs to get to the foul line more often.
And he hits them both. Game tied at nine. Aaron Harrison. Decker with the rebound.
And if you're Wisconsin, those are the shots you want Andrew and Aaron taking. Elbow shots, not shots at the rim, because that means you can keep bodies on bodies and have a chance to compete on a defensive backcourt.
Wisconsin goes to its fabled swing offense. Koenig knocks down his second shot of the game. Huge role for Koenig in the win over Arizona.
And Decker with the steal at the other end.
You know, this is kind of weird of me to say this, but Wisconsin's probably a quicker team than Kentucky.
Here's Nigel Hayes.
This is the most athletic team Bo Ryan has ever had. Is that a charge or a block? It's going to be a block on Trayvon
and
Jackson.
I thought that was the right call. Oh, initially I thought he slid. I take that. Yeah. I stand corrected.
I don't know if it's a charge, a block, or a travel.
Well, they also have in the collegiate game what's called a blarge.
Oh, they do.
Yes, okay. Well, the official could actually call it both ways, and then it would go to the arrow. So,
never heard of that.
Yeah, that is actually a call in the collegiate game.
A blarge.
I would change the name.
Maybe to a. A chalk?
A chalk? Yeah, that's what I call it.
Second consecutive block call here. Koenig should be called for the foul, not Hayes. That one was a good call. What I've seen, guys, and Greg, you know this very well, Bo Ryan, when the calls go against him, he influences the game as well as any coach I've seen. Just with his ability to get on and stay on the officials. And he, I really believe he impacts the game in that manner.
They did give that foul to Hayes.
Ooh.
Steve, it's a great point too, because you know, you often wonder what the objective of a coach is. And really, the officials, like the players, can be influenced
sure.
in terms of what they do on the court. And Bo Ryan, to your point, and I think Calipari does a good job of it as well.
Duguay Dukan, then for the first time, number 13 for Wisconsin. This young man right here will take the three. You've known him since he was just a little kid, Steve.
Yeah, both of us, actually. Yeah. His father, a scout for the Chicago Bulls. There's Harrison.
Marcus Lee trying to save it. Right into the hands of Gasser. Gasser finds Brust on the wing. Three-point shot. Got it. A 7-0 run for the Badgers. And Kentucky calls the timeout.
How about the chemistry on display here? Terrific job with the steal. Brust in rhythm, dropping it from beyond. Welcome back as Wisconsin in the midst of a 7-0 run. Take a look at this play here by Josh Gasser. Watch him right here on the split of these two guys. He also has recognition of where Brust is. And then how about the pass on the money in rhythm, which allowed for Brust to gather and knock down that triple. Terrific play there by the Badgers. Showing some quickness in the open floor.
And the three-point shot by Brust, the only senior starter.
And I think it's important not to underestimate Wisconsin's offensive firepower. I mean, this club was fourth in the country in offensive efficiency. They average more points than both Kentucky and Florida. So this is a quick team that can get out and explode if you don't get back defensively.
Andrew Harrison missing that three ball. And that's Marcus Lee, who came on so strong in the regional final. Koenig. What a rebound. Outside, Brust. Yes!
How about a little bit of Kentucky's own medicine there? He just outwilled him for that offensive rebound and found Brust again in rhythm.
Yeah, it was Dukin. Dukin. 6 points by Brust in 42 seconds. The all-time three-point shooter in Wisconsin history. And that's two for Aaron Harrison.
And that's the first time you've seen either Andrew or Aaron able to get, in essence, all the way to the rim to get that score.
And that ends a 10-0 run for the Badgers, who have Kaminsky back on the floor, who has barely touched it. Russ for a third one. No. Foul outside. And it's going to be Kaminsky's first. Celebrate all four teams that made it here with official gear from the NCAA store. Team apparel and all the gear at NCAA.com/shop.
You know, there's been so much talk, Jim, about why Kentucky has improved. Some of it is just the maturity of all these freshmen as the season has gone on. But I think the big adjustment John Calipari has made is they're going much more to this dribble drive offense. Early in the season, it was more post up, going inside out. He's playing a lot more like his Memphis teams. There's a block now on Jackson. That's a commercial, but playing a lot more like the Derrick Rose, Tyreek Evans, Memphis teams that Calipari coached.
And I want to make sure that you know that was not on Kaminsky. The one before was on Koenig. So, two on Jackson, though, with that last block foul.
Welcome back. Wisconsin with a six-point lead. Take a look at this play here. Trayvon Jackson, I think, has perfect position. If anything, it's a no-call. I just think that's a poor decision there by the official. But more importantly, look at this here. That reaction right there could warrant a technical, which would then have been his third foul. Two free throws. That could have been a really big play had the official decided to tee him up.
And his first one could have been a charge also. This is huge. I mean, Trayvon Jackson, I think, is the most important player on this team. He's the one who represents their toughness and their grit. And now Kaminsky, who has not scored, not even taken a shot, he's going to have to take over the offense.
Andrew Harrison. And the ball all the way outside to Gasser. So it's Koenig at the point on this trip down the floor, with Jackson sitting with the two. And Gasser is halfway down and spins out.
Hey,
to Dakari Johnson, and he taps it in.
And that's where I think the Harrisons have also really improved at their attack and transition, either to get to the rim or to find the teammate, much better now than they were earlier in the season.
That's on James Young, his first. Let's go over to Tracy.
Well, guys, you're just talking about the Harrison brothers and attacking the basket. Well, that's exactly what John Calipari told them in the huddle. The last two timeouts, he's been really on them. He wants them to move the ball and drive it just like they've done all tournament long, guys.
Thank you, Tracy. And the pass comes back out to Brust. Kaminsky. Still not able to get free for an attempt. Gosser. And it's Andrew Harrison.
Well, Ryan can't believe it. He's saying if those fouls were on Jackson on the block, how come that wasn't a foul with Gosser?
And Randall gets his first points of the night.
And really good decision there by Julius Randle. Defense was loaded to him. They were going to give him the mid-range. And there he showed the ability to knock it down.
This foul on Andrew Harrison, his first.
And this is an area where I think he's got to, Steve, continue to improve. To be able to knock down that jump shot, when you have the kind of quickness and first step he has, it almost makes you unguardable at this level with his athletic ability.
Well, it's coming. I mean, he's got a soft touch on that ball. He's getting better by the game.
Decker. Back out to Koenig.
Boy, Dakari Johnson has done an excellent job staying in Kaminsky, but Koenig, as a result, gets all the way to the hoop. Dakari Johnson stayed with Kaminsky on the perimeter. That opened up the lane.
Koenig, who averages 3 points a game, has six.
And remember, no Willie Cauley-Stein, so they don't have the shot blocking on the floor when you can get Johnson out on the perimeter, having to guard Kaminsky at the three-point line.
Now you can see Wisconsin's strategy here, just forcing Kentucky to the perimeter, but on the offensive glass, as usual, a major factor here for the Wildcats.
Yeah, Dakari Johnson. There's Decker. And reaching in was Aaron Harrison. His first.
You see that left-hand drive here, really strong move. Oh, he tweaked that ankle. That right ankle, when he came down, wasn't able to plant completely. Can't really see it from that angle. You can see him grimacing there.
And he still is.
There it is, right there.
Oh, yeah, that little wiggle on the landing. And Decker hits the first free throw. Randall is hobbling for sure. And he's coming out. Young and Hawkins onto the floor for Coach Calipari. Of course, Randall has been talking about coming to this Final Four since the day it was awarded back in 08. He's a Dallas kid, and this has always been the goal for 6 years, to come back home, take a team to a title.
So his goal at the age of 12 was, was to play in the Final Four in North Texas.
And he said he called his mom and even told her, Dallas got a Final Four. And I'm going to be playing in it one day when it's there. There's Harrison. It slides off the rim. They're taking Randall inside. Already without Cauley-Stein, and now Randall, who, of course, is their best player. And the freshman of the year in the SEC, and 24 double-doubles and all of that.
And Dakari Johnson is tired right now. He's been flying all over the floor, trying to defend. He's a big guy who likes to stay in the post, as you see Randall trying to run it off. I think Johnson may get a rest here. This might be our first glimpse at Marcus Lee.
Yeah, Randall just trying to find some room to walk it off as Kaminsky comes in for Hayes. Hayes has just picked up his second foul.
This is where you got to go inside to Frank Kaminsky. Lee, very slight, just a freshman. I think Kaminsky's strength, it's probably too much for Lee on the block, but they've got to do a good job executing to get Kaminsky in rhythm rather than just a straight post.
And you're also seeing here early on for a team in Wisconsin, second in the country in committing the fewest fouls. They've already committed six here, and two guys who are going to be important, Hayes and Jackson, both on the bench with two.
Here's Kaminsky. They went right to him with Lee having come in. Let's go over to Tracy for an update.
Well, guys, we saw Julius Randle trying to run it off, and he came off and he said, I just rolled it. And right now he's sitting on the bench with the athletic trainer, and he's starting to take off that right shoe. I don't know what the trainer's going to do. Actually, now he's just tying it tighter. He's not even taking it off, and he's just chatting right now with the trainer. Nothing more. He's just taking some drink of water. We'll see if he can try and get back in there, guys.
Okay, Tracy, and we had another look at it. And what did you think when you saw it?
About the ankle? Absolutely, Turner. It also looked like it kind of caught Kaminsky's heel a little bit as well.
Here's Kaminsky with the nifty move underneath.
Lee can't handle him down there. And so Kentucky's going to have to bring help. And Wisconsin, they execute so well offensively. They'll find ways to get him the ball.
Oh, wow. Marcus Lee was hanging out all over that rim in Indianapolis.
Again, just a great read. And Lee is going to pick up a foul here against Kaminsky. It looked like he kind of baited him, Steve, into that play.
He did. You know, there was a flop from Kaminsky, but Lee was so pumped up from the dunk. I think he wanted to sort of let him know, watch the play, just a simple pick and roll. And this is what Lee does, just jumps over everybody. But at the other end, he ends up fouling Kaminsky. How many dunks like this did you guys see from Lee last game against Michigan?
Yeah, we saw
five.
Four. He had four dunks, and he made a great move in the lane for a fifth basket. And he made the all-regional team.
And now he wants to leave early and go to the NBA.
He hadn't scored more than a basket since a game back in mid-November. He had five in that one, plus some other key plays, some blocks and rebounds.
Kaminsky calling for the ball, but the shot clock now a factor, so they'll go pick and roll with Koenig.
Koenig! Oh. And that counts for Decker.
And how good has Bronson Koenig been here early on for Wisconsin?
Koenig is going to be a star, just a freshman, terrific vision, finding Decker, Wisconsin, with the five-point lead. Both teams shooting the ball well. Wisconsin getting a huge lift with Trayvon Jackson's foul trouble. Bronson Koenig, 3 of 4, 6 points. He's got an assist. This is a big-time talent coming out of La Crosse. Turned down North Carolina, among others. Wanted to play for Bo Ryan. He's going to be a star in the future for this Wisconsin program.
Well, it's been a star performance in the first half here as they've had to go with him. Jackson down with the two fouls. Here's Randle back on the floor.
Gosser is so strong. You wouldn't expect him to handle Randle, but he sure did there.
Harrison got it to go. Andrew Harrison.
Andrew Harrison now really starting to get deeper into the paint along with Aaron. They're starting to get to the rim with a little more consistency than was the case earlier in this game.
It's their whole offense now, really. It's just penetration and offensive rebounds.
Underneath, Kaminsky back out high, quick pass, Koenig, got the three.
Talk about a coming out party. People in Wisconsin knew who he was before this game. I'm not sure anybody else did. They will now.
But how about the ball movement, the post up there by Kaminsky and the great read.
Once again, Young makes that move. Ball on the floor to Gosser.
There it is again. Penetration from Kentucky. The battle on the glass. Wisconsin has to stay relatively even. If they do, they've got a great chance to win this game.
It's Koenig driving in. And it's off Kentucky.
Take a look. We talked about the difficult guard that Kaminsky is. It's also the ability to make plays. That pass there that was pinpoint to Gosser and the trust in the freshman Koenig to knock down that shot. That's what makes Wisconsin in the half court so difficult to deal with, because they create matchup problems for their opponents.
The last ship, find the cure, save the world, from Michael Bay, executive producer of Transformers, the new series, The Last Ship, Sunday, January 22nd at 9, 8 Central, only on TNT. That was on Andrew Harrison, and he has two now. Be a 1-1 here for Brust.
You know, one of the other things about Wisconsin, people always say, you know, they're an unorthodox team and they're hard to guard. One reason they're so difficult to guard is they make all five guys defend. Curls, pin down, flares, cuts.
And then top of that, Greg, seven of the eight rotation players can all make threes. They get great spacing to go along with that cutting, and it's a nightmare to go.
Young to Poitras.
And how many times have we seen James Young get to his left hand? That's a design play there, though, where he comes off that curl, and he knows that Poitras is going to be there if there's a hedge from Poitras' man.
Johnson back on the floor to defend Kaminsky after a breather. And another three. Tapped out. That was Kaminsky who kept the possession for the Badgers with the tap.
Johnson back on Kaminsky, so a little tougher for Kaminsky to score inside.
DeBrust, he's got Hawkins on him. Kaminsky with another offensive rebound. Stepping up, Brust. This time it's Poitras who boxed out Kaminsky.
Love the ball fake, though, from Ben Brust, bringing himself up for a wide open shot.
Kari Johnson. After the whistle, Kaminsky hit the floor.
But I think before that, there was a foul, I think, on Kaminsky. Here, that reach in right there.
He shoves him, no question. And Kaminsky does a nice job selling it, but watch the shove right here. Kari Johnson extends here on the officials now.
They can look at that, but that's a lot of that too is the momentum of Dakari Johnson carrying him into Kaminsky there.
But he hits him in the face and then follows through and extends
Let's hope that I don't see that being flagrant. I mean, there's not enough there. I mean, it's more about the fact that where he's really swinging his arms. He just kind of falls. I mean, he absolutely extends, but I don't think there's any necessity to warrant a flagrant foul in a situation like that. You saw how
he sold
Kaminsky sold that. But don't reward guys for selling or flopping.
Well, but you also have to penalize guys for hitting someone in the face and pushing them down. I think that's flagrant. I really do.
I don't. I think if you swing it or if the force is excessive, I get it. And you know what? They may call it, but I would disagree with that call if they decided to.
Here are the flagrant foul. 1 and 2. Of course, this all happened way after they'd already called a foul on Kaminsky.
Which is why I think it would be flagrant, because the whistle has already blown. The play should stop, but the momentum carries Dakari in, and then the extension with contact to the face. That's kind of the key there, Greg.
That's a good point, but the play had stopped, but Kaminsky didn't stop. He still made a play on the ball after the whistle had blown. So that's my point. It's not Dakari Johnson. The whistle had blown well before he went up for the shot. That's the foul.
And then he continues
with the play there. And that's a flop. I'm sorry. I'm not going to give you a flagrant on that flop. And if they do, I'd be really disappointed in the
official. You know what we're proving right here? How difficult it is to be a ref, because one of them might think the way you do, one of them might think the way I do.
True.
They've got to figure this out as a group, how they want to call it.
They're going to come over here and explain it to us. Dead ball technical foul on Dakari Johnson.
So instead of flagrant.
So it's not flagrant. Technical. So we're both right.
Right.
We're both wrong, right. I just don't like that call. Because why are you as a defensive player able to continue to make contact on that play? And it's a tough call, because I don't think the intent was it to do anything malicious here, but it doesn't have to be. I understand
that.
It's the shove right there.
Yeah.
And Greg, the reason Kaminsky has to continue to defend is so he doesn't know if there's going to be continuation on the play. So he's got to deny Johnson's ability to finish
the play. But it's dead ball, though. Isn't that not correct? Wouldn't the ball be dead, though?
But how does he know when the whistle blows whether continuation will be called? He's got to keep his hands up, but Johnson gets the call for shoving him in the face. I think the officials handled this the right way.
I didn't see enough. I understand the dead ball. That you could go with, but My concern was more about the flake.
So first it'll be Johnson at the line to shoot the free throw. On the contact by Kaminsky.
Okay, now I'm confused.
Yeah.
They already called the foul on Kaminsky first.
Who was the technical foul on?
And then it's on Dakari Johnson.
Okay, well, they're in the bonus.
Now they'll go to the other end with Brust. Let's go over to Tracy.
Well, guys, I had a chance to speak with head of officiating John Adams, and he told me it is a foul, and then it is a dead ball foul, personal contact after the foul. And that is why they are shooting these free throws, and the ball will go back to Wisconsin after this.
So Dakari Johnson made one of two. And Russ got them both, and it'll be Badger ball.
Russ with 10 points now. Quick start. And how about Wisconsin from the line? 8 of 8. And 4 of 8 for Kentucky.
You guys notice anything with Randall since he had to come back out after turning an ankle?
Well, he hasn't had the ball a whole lot. I think we're going to see the results of that sprain. Usually when you sprain it, it takes a little while for the effects to show. We'll keep an eye on him here the remainder of the first half.
And he's also now going to be matched up with Kaminsky, which at times will take him away from the basket.
Kaminsky, who still has only taken one shot and made it.
And Kentucky's bringing the double on the block every time he touches the ball down there.
They feed it down to Kaminsky. Goes right back out. Koenig short with that one. And Randall. As Koenig reached in and knocked it out of his hands.
Boy, what a great fight by Wisconsin just to contain penetration and come up with a steal. Koenig, nice play.
And it's going to be a second on Hawkins. It'll be a 1-1. One and one for Bronson Koenig.
Shocking number here. You look at the stats. Koenig played in all 36 games. Took 6 free throws all season. So not a guy who's accustomed to being at the line.
And a part of that's because the majority of his shots have come from the 3-point line, even though he's shown an ability in this game to be able to put the ball on the floor and get to the rim.
So he earns a second one. Get complete coverage of the NCAA Division I Women's Tournament at NCAA.com. And Vito Brown seeing his first action for the Badgers, number 30. As Kaminsky goes to the bench again. And now the Badgers' lead is 9. That's the biggest of the game. And it's Brust.
And that was an example there. You see how Gosser getting up slowly there, but you see how Aaron Harrison couldn't turn the corner against Wisconsin's guards. They're a little bit stronger than anybody they've really seen in this tournament, and they've done a good job of keeping Andrew and Harrison away from the rim.
I like the matchup for Wisconsin. They're used to playing this style of defense, the pack line where they really contain penetration and guard the lane. They're doing a nice job of it, but they're also fighting for the rebounds. And it's a 12-11 count right now for Kentucky. Wisconsin will take that.
Blocked by Vito Brown, but then put back by Randall. And a foul. Showing no effects with that.
No, no problem with the ankle here. And that's where he makes his living, folks. The ability to attack that offensive glass. Kentucky by 7, down 7.
Polls and featured groups. Go to cbssports.com/masters and masters.com. And full coverage next weekend on CBS Sports. So coming out of a foul by Vito Brown, and Randall has the chance complete the three-point play, and he does. Kaminsky's back on the floor.
I think Wisconsin's got to feel pretty good. I mean, two fouls each on Hayes and Jackson, and yet they've been able to execute offensively and continue to battle on the glass. But against Kentucky, you have to sustain it for 40 minutes. You guys have seen it. I mean, they overwhelm you over time.
They've been at this kind of same point almost every tournament game, down 7 or 8 late first half. Here's Decker. And that's going to be on Aaron Harrison.
It's the best I've seen Decker look in this tournament because he's attacking. He's so athletic that he's not settling for jump shots. He's forcing the issue, drawing contact. This will be his 5th and 6th free throws.
2 on each of the Harrisons and double bonus. So 2 shots for Decker.
And how about Vera, 11 of 11 from the free throw line here in his first half. And you know, the other thing about Decker I think that's helped his game is Kaminsky. Kaminsky's ability to play inside and out, even that play, he drew help and allowed that angle for Decker to attack the rim there. And Decker's making better decisions, I think, as well.
Jared Paulson comes in, the senior from Nicholasville, Kentucky, as they put both Harrisons on the bench with the 2 fouls.
Paulson has seen 4 different waves of freshman classes come through since he's been there. He's the lone mainstay from 4 years ago.
There's Young. That call is on Gosser, his first. So you got 4 different Wildcats with 2. You've got Trey Jackson and Nigel Hayes with 2 on the Wisconsin side.
And these free throws here, one are extremely important, but more importantly, the last 2:34. You're not going to have either of the Harrisons in the game. You're not going to have the ability or luxury of their size on both ends of the floor. This stretch here where you're already down 7, possibly 6 points, how does Kentucky stay connected in terms of not getting behind too far? And if you're Wisconsin, you don't want to get to a point where you get complacent here and waste possession.
Kentucky's had to go 9 players deep with Poitras, the foul issues.
And now Poitras gets his shot at Kaminsky. I think we've seen 4 different defenders on Frank Kaminsky to this point.
Trying to feed it to Kaminsky. Poitras knocks it out with 10 on the shot clock. Bo Ryan, 13 years at Wisconsin, 13 trips to the NCAA tournament. And again, Decker looks up, realizes it. 7 to shoot. Drives on Randall. Off the glass. Oh, what a tough one.
And we talked about that matchup at the top. Remember, which would win out? Will it be the power of Randall or the finesse and quickness of Decker? And so far, Decker has held his own.
Here's Hawkins. How about that? Paulson to Hawkins, backups, and they beat the Badger defense.
Well, Ryan not thrilled because they've done a pretty good job of containing penetration for the most part. Not there.
And that was Koenig missing with the left hand. And here's Randall trailing, and 2 more for Kentucky.
And just like that, with your starting backcourt and center on the bench, Kentucky's done the job defensively, and you can see now the intensity in the crowd starting to get into it.
Down to Gosser. Working on Hawkins, and it rolls off the rim. Big minutes right here by the Kentucky reserves. Just when they were 8 down, they're getting valuable play out of the likes of Paulson and Hawkins and Poitras. Here's Paulson. Tapped up Poitras, no. And it's going against the Wildcats. Coming up, AT&T at the half. EJ and Greg and all the guys will have their first half analysis. And a look back at UConn's victory over Florida. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Poitras hit with his first.
Big sequence there. I mean, that very easily could have been a tip-in and a 2-point game. Instead, Decker, who has made all six of his free throws, gets a chance to extend this lead back to six.
Double bonus. And the Badgers 13 for 13 at the line.
And really, if you're Kentucky, Steve, at this point, I don't think no matter the outcome this last 49 seconds, you're going to feel a lot better about where you are in this game because of the foul trouble and the fact that you've had to have Holson and Hawkins on the floor here for this last 2.5. And they've done a pretty solid job for the Wildcats.
You can say the same thing about Wisconsin with their foul trouble. Yeah. I think both coaches should feel pretty good about it.
And that's Randall over Kaminsky. Timeout called by the Badgers. O'Ryan will set up a last shot here before the half. Randall, nothing wrong with that ankle as he goes up high for the two.
Jackson were out, but they had done their damage with Hayes and Jackson on the bench. They had gotten a 9-point lead with about 2.5 to go, and now all of a sudden you've allowed Kentucky to get some confidence and some momentum here down the stretch.
On the other hand, Kaminsky with one field goal, Jackson and Hayes with the foul trouble, and you got the lead going in. So I don't know, I feel pretty good.
I feel good with the lead at the end, that's for sure.
Right.
There you go. 10 seconds now, and Koenig with Young watching him. Now with five. Koenig looks up, takes the shot. Rebound Kentucky, and we reach halftime. Halftime with the Badgers leading at 40-36. Led by Decker with 12, Koenig with 11, and Brust with 10. Those three players, 33 of Wisconsin's 40. And let's go over to Tracy with Bo Ryan.
Thanks a lot. A little run there, but how do you like how your team has been able to handle their physicality and size in this first half?
Well, we've gotten a little foul trouble. We know how powerful they can be on the glass if they're allowed to get their way. So what we're trying to do is get in their way.
How about the job that Koenig has done? Kaminsky only 2 points, but Koenig has really stepped up here.
Bronson's done a great job. Trey picked up some fouls. He's going to have to be ready to go in the second half, of course. But Bronson did an excellent job of running the show. We got our points per possession pretty well, and that's what you need to do. And the point guard is usually responsible for that.
Appreciate it. Thanks a lot, Jim.
That's the end of the first half with the Badgers leading at 40-36. There's Brust gunning for 3 of his 10. Kentucky with a little flurry at the end of the half. We'll send you to AT&T at the half after these messages.
Couple minutes, we saw the athleticism on the front line start to take an effect with the offensive rebounding. I think John Calipari has to be pretty happy with where things are. They didn't play that well. They did shoot well, but they've overwhelmed everybody in the second half with their rebounding. That's the challenge. Continue to play and continue to pound the glass.
All right, let's hear what you heard back by the locker room there, Tracy.
Well, thanks, Jim. I had a chance to speak with John Calipari coming back out, and he was happy being down just 2 baskets. And it's like you mentioned, Greg, he said the magnitude of the moment and these freshmen, they were nervous to start, but he really liked how they played down the stretch there. But he told them in the locker room, if you're not going to play with fight, I don't care if you're starters or you're not, you are not going to play. So I need to see fight from every one of you out there, or else you're sitting on the bench the rest of this game, guys.
Yeah, he told us last week in Indianapolis, it could either be fearful or fearless. And if I sense anything close to fearful, you're sitting. Fearless, you're on the floor. It was not a great first half for the Harrison Twins, each with 2 fouls. Here's Randall right away taking it in and not getting the call as Randall hits the floor. Wisconsin's got the numbers. And Brust, seeing a 7-footer closing in on him, doesn't take the shot.
Cross match underneath, so Harrison is on Kaminsky. Wisconsin's got to move the ball and take advantage of the mismatch.
Now they switch back now. Johnson able to get on Kaminsky, who had only that one shot in the first half and made it. Brust set up top of the key, and Kaminsky taps it back out to Gosser, to Jackson. In trouble. finds Decker. Decker's got it.
And I really believe that three-pointer fell because of his ability to get to the free throw line in that first half. He's got confidence with his jump shot now. Great effort by Kaminsky and crew keeping it alive. And Decker rewards his teammates from beyond.
And Kentucky calls timeout. You've got to take note that every tournament game, the Badgers have come out in the second half with big runs. And they open up with a three, and then there's the timeout called by Calipari. And here's one guy who's had a pretty good sports year already with a Super Bowl victory. And his Badgers is here cheering him on. Wilson.
You know, took them to a Rose Bowl. And Jim, you looked at that graphic. One of the reasons Wisconsin has made those second half runs, they make really good adjustments. We already saw a quick adjustment from Bo Ryan. He had Frank Kaminsky face up on his post up. Rather than have his back to the basket, he faced up and went around Johnson. Meanwhile, Randall getting himself going.
Here's Kaminsky coming off a pick down low. That pass chased down by Kaminsky. Jackson, 2 seconds to shoot. Kaminsky leans in, and that never hit the rim.
And really, probably the best defensive possession Kentucky's had in quite a while. Very disciplined. And you see Julius Randle here just exploding up over the help defense of Kaminsky there to get that finish.
And that goes as the first Badger turnover in 18 minutes as Randle sits down with Poitras coming onto the floor.
I think Decker's got to be happy to see Randle go to the bench. I mean, he's a load down there for Decker on the block.
Here's Dakari Johnson. And now Young. And he makes the move one more time.
The left hand again. You hate to beat a dead horse, but you've got to know the personnel you're competing against if you're Wisconsin. And James Young is a left-hand dominant player here. What a beautiful finish there as he split the defenders, and that's a huge basket for the young Wildcat.
He has that ability to kind of get his body in any position he needs to get the shot on.
And he's such a good shooter from the perimeter that Wisconsin is so conscious of closing out on him. They're over closing out, allowing him to get to the left.
And he gets a four-point trip out of it and brings the Wildcats within one. That timeout by Calipari looked like a good one now, as Kentucky, just like that, has a chance to get the lead. Harrison, followed up, no, by Johnson. Gets it back, and Kaminsky commits his second foul, and Kentucky's back ahead. Its first lead since 7-5.
And it's been the theme of this team the entire postseason. They've been down big early, but they found a way to rally, and that typically includes attacking the offensive glass.
Well, I said this in the first half. I think it bears repeating. Kentucky figured out their best offense was not to throw the ball into the big men, which they were doing early in the season. It's just to let their guards penetrate and collapse the defense and let their bigs attack the offensive boards. That's why Kentucky has 14 more turnovers than assists in the NCAA tournament, and yet here they are in the Final Four.
A 9-0 stretch coming out of the Kentucky timeout call. Most of the crowd right now on its feet as Kentucky is making a run. Young.
Wow, what a play.
How did that happen?
Bo Ryan thought that it was an offensive interference. He's not going to get that call.
Well, It started at this end with the steal. Young reaching around on Hayes. And then Poitras, the Badgers wanted basket interference. How did you see it?
I thought it was the right call. That the ball was short of the rim. It's on its way down, but it has to have an opportunity to be in the cylinder. And on that play there, it was not. And Poitras, who's had these kinds of plays throughout this run in the tournament there, with another big one for the Wildcats.
Trayvon Jackson sits down. And now Koenig working it hard. And that's off Koenig.
And now Koenig, you know,
maybe trying to do a little too much.
And to his credit, Bo Ryan went to him early. Remember, he pulled Trayvon Jackson here early in this half. And Koenig not having the same success. Wisconsin's going to have to settle down and start playing more through Kaminsky, I think. I don't think they've utilized him enough, especially when he wasn't as much of a factor offensively in the first half.
Harrison follows up his own goal. For Marcus Lee.
And suddenly you look at the rebounding totals, 25-14 for Kentucky. It was even late in the first half, but this is what happens against Kentucky. They overwhelm you on the boards.
They were plus five in the first half. They're already plus six here, only about 4 minutes into the second.
Well, that was trying to go to Kaminsky. Kentucky will be heading to the line. Under 16 timeout. What a turnaround here. You got to give Calipari credit. He didn't wait long after that three-point shot to call a timeout. And his team responded. They have scored 13 unanswered with free throws coming up out of the break. There's among the honorees, Ohio State's Aaron Kraft, Joe Harris from Virginia, Michigan's Jordan Gordon. Good for them. Great kids in the NABC. Jim Haney's got to be proud of those student-athletes in his organization, recognizing them here. Here's Young. And that makes it a 14-point run.
Trayvon Jackson back into the ballgame for Wisconsin. They've lost their poise here to start the second half. They're giving up offensive boards, but they're not executing offensively. I think they've got to get the ball back to Kaminsky, play through him, settle down, and get a couple of good offensive possessions. Their offense ultimately will help their defense.
Jackson to Gosser. Kentucky's definitely stepped up the intensity at this end. As Gosser would shut off baseline. Rust. Five to shoot. Jackson shot. Bad pass. Pretty much out of control.
Their defense, Kentucky's defense, has picked up dramatically. I think Bo Ryan's club must have made, 12, 13 passes on that possession, but there was nothing there. The recovery, the effort by the Wildcats is impressive.
Particularly, you saw Young there on Rust, able to recover from that pump fake. Kentucky's defensive intensity and discipline far better in the second half.
And a miss by the Wildcats. Wisconsin scoreless for 4.5 minutes as Kaminsky fails to hit it, but followed up for two by Dugan.
And even though Kaminsky doesn't score, Wisconsin scores by virtue of going to Kaminsky on that possession, created that offensive rebound.
Tapped out to Jackson. That tap in by Dukin into the 15-point run. Here's Dukin looking for three more. That's huge.
Duyay Dukin.
Another momentum swing. It's amazing how quickly it happens. But the poise of Wisconsin, which is really their hallmark, they found it again the last couple of possessions, and they look like the team we've seen.
There's Young. And that one bounces off the front into the arms of Kaminsky and ahead to Jackson. Oh. Down on the blocks, Kaminsky, and that's rejected by Lee and picked off the floor by Harrison. Andrew Harrison scores.
Andrew Harrison.
That was one of the few times we've seen Kaminsky not get his feet right on that move. Throughout this tournament, he's made pivots that have just astounded you for a big man, but he lost control there against Lee.
Here's Brust. Comes back with a three for the Badgers.
And you talked about the focus returning for the Badgers offensively. Much better execution, and also they've done a better job earlier in the shot clock.
You saw Ben Brust's mother celebrating her son's three. Kentucky, that one spins out somehow.
Wisconsin now taking care of those defensive boards, allowing them to get out and run and get some early offense.
They've got Kaminsky guarded by Andrew Harrison. Size advantage, but now they collapse on Kaminsky. Brust, who's hit three threes, now in the paint and heading to the line where Wisconsin has not missed.
And we've talked about it, but again, by going inside to Kaminsky, you put Kentucky in rotation. And then you get opportunities on the kickouts to attack and get to the paint and potentially get to the free throw line.
First foul on Young. First foul of the second half on the Wildcats. There's his mom, Barb. The Brust family from Hawthorne Woods, Illinois. Hey, watch the games live, including the Final Four TeamCast with NCAA March Madness Live. Download the app for your Amazon Kindle, iPhone, iPad, or Android device by visiting NCAA.com/March Madness.
You know, guys, coming into this game, this is a lot like I thought it would go from the standpoint that there would be ebbs and flows. Both teams would have momentum swings, and it ultimately would come down to execution down the stretch, and thus far, that's playing out.
There's Andrew Harrison.
Kaminsky on the bench, so no shot blocking. And you look at Nigel Hayes and Jackson, the foul trouble took their rhythm. They've never really been able to get anything going.
Wisconsin takes the lead back. Duca now with 8 points here to fuel this comeback.
Duca made 13 three-pointers all season. Coming into tonight, here he is in the Final Four, knocking down two huge ones.
And how about for the Badgers? It was Koenig off the bench in the first half. It's been Dukin here in this half with his energy and effectiveness offensively, getting the crowd and the Badgers back into the game.
Harrison drove and scored, but then Duye Dukin answers back for the lead. 444, biggest crowd to ever watch a tournament game, or two games. The first one that went to Connecticut, 63-53. And now we've got 11 and a half minutes to play to find out the Huskies' opponent Monday night. Wisconsin has come back from eight down in this half to lead by one after a Kentucky 15-0 spurt to start the half. Drew Harrison, fight for the rebound. If it's a jump ball, the arrow belongs to the Badgers. And it is Wisconsin ball. Let's go to Tracy.
Well, guys, John Calipari continuing to hound the Harrison, specifically Andrew. You just saw him right here. He said drive to the basket. He said no more jump shots, just drive to the basket. That's what he's looking for out of Andrew Harrison right now, guys.
Harrison, 3 out of 10 from the floor. Thank you, Tracy.
But that's where I think, even though Trayvon Jackson hasn't scored a nice cut until that moment, he's played well in the second half in initiating offense, but more importantly, in keeping Andrew Harrison from getting to the rim. He's done a terrific job with his strength and ability to move his feet to keep him out of the paint.
Randall. Back out to Aaron Harrison. They lost it on the drive, and they say it's off the Badgers with 9 to shoot.
This is what Wisconsin does to you offensively. They just set so many screens, they spread the floor, and eventually you're going to get an opening if the defense lets its guard down. Beautiful pass by Nigel Hayes.
5 to shoot. Harrison steps in for the 2.
Wisconsin's basically just begging Kentucky to shoot. I mean, they're playing all 5 players in the paint, going under every screen and roll. Kentucky only 1 of 3 from the 3-point line. So this is just story of Kentucky and their ability to get to the paint, as Hayes does there for Wisconsin.
The Big Ten Freshman of the Year driving for the basket. Also the 6th man of the year in the Big Ten. Right back, rattling out, and Dakari Johnson.
And even though he doesn't score, again, the attack of the rim is oftentimes been Kentucky's best offense, their ability to go get the second shot.
That's their version of an assist.
Yeah.
You know, just dribble in and throw it up there.
Javon Jackson with the jumper.
He got it.
That's a 2.
That might get it going. You said it, Greg. He's been playing well the last few minutes with aggressiveness. That jumper coming off that crossover, now he gets a little swagger to his step.
And the thing about a point guard, you don't always judge his effectiveness by his stats. You judge it by how his team functions. And you've seen Wisconsin the last 5 minutes or so be really effective in their half-court offense.
And Andrew Harrison driving in. And that's going against the Badgers. They keep trying to draw the charge, and they don't get the call the whole game.
And this is the 3rd one that Trayvon Jackson has attempted to take. And he kind of leans over to the left, and I think that's why he got called for the foul. This is kind of the Rajon Rondo play, former Kentucky Wildcat. And Jackson just wasn't quite there with his hands held high. But that's the 3rd block he's been called for on close plays.
So 3 overall it is. That one looked like the right call. And 1 more coming. Coke Zero, ask you, are you a real fan? Hashtag prove it. Visit the Coke Zero social arena in March Madness Live.
You know, the one thing, though, even though they get a block for Wisconsin, that's important about that play is Kentucky knows that the help is going to be there. And so even that, as you see Andrew and Aaron's parents, even though you don't get the charge, when you know the help's going to be there, it makes you a little more tentative with your attack off the dribble.
They bring Hawkins in at guard for Kentucky and sit Andrew Harrison. Meanwhile, Trayvon Jackson went to the bench during the free throws. Here's Kaminsky. There's the spin move, and he gets the basket.
And that's the one. When he faces up against Dakari Johnson, that's his advantage. Johnson's done a terrific job on him down on the block when Frank has played with his back to the basket.
And Aaron Harrison tapped out the plus. That basket by Kaminsky, his first since the 8:39 mark in the first half. Because we haven't seen him shoot the outside shot, which he's got a deft touch. Russ. As Wisconsin snaps it around. And that's a turnover.
How about the footwork, though, at 7 feet, the ability to change directions? That's the hardest thing for bigs to do, is to go one way full speed and then be able to reverse pivot or direction there. And part of the reason he's more effective there as well, Steve, is because they can't set their defense to go double when he's on the perimeter. You know, they're set to double when he touches it with his back to the basket. And the adjustment now that he's making is moving his game to the perimeter where he can take advantage of that foot speed and footwork with Dakari Johnson.
Randall has checked back in. It's Young with the jumper, and he's having a good night.
James Young.
Young with 17, tops for the Wildcats.
I like that play. We've seen that a few times from Kentucky. I prefer that, a little weak side pin down, rather than the just straight penetration, because Wisconsin's waiting for that.
And outside, a foul on Kentucky. called on Randall. His first. Well, it's been a good one. Can't wait to see what the last 7:26 is going to bring. Game summary from three. It belongs to Wisconsin. In the paint, big advantage, Kentucky. Young was 17. Kaminsky off the 28 in the West Regional Final has been held to 4.
Well, in this age, Steve, of analytics, I'm a big believer in winning the freeze, threes, and tees battle. Free throws, three-pointers, and turnovers, and that's been the difference for Wisconsin here, whereas Kentucky's more of a traditional power team. They've been able to dominate the paint.
So they come back out of the break, and again, they'll go with Koenig instead of Jackson.
Jackson with those three fouls, but both players have played well at points during this game. Now Kaminsky going right around DeCorey Johnson picks up the foul.
Tracy, you hear anything in that timeout?
Well, guys, Cal not happy with the body language of his young players, both Julius Randle and Andrew Harrison. He was all over Harrison saying, stop doing that. No one cares. Show some energy. He doesn't want to see all those frustrated looks. Some of the stuff that they did earlier on in this year and they haven't seen throughout this tournament, he said, start playing. Stop showing all your frustration out there, guys.
Third foul on DeCorey Johnson, who goes to the bench. Poitras out there now. Wisconsin's hit its last six from the floor. And again, it's going to be on Poitras on the hold on Kaminsky.
You know, as you take a look at the replay, the one thing about the game, though, from Kentucky standpoint, they've not seen a team like Wisconsin. We talked about Kentucky being a power team and Wisconsin being the most unorthodox team in terms of their style of play. So that's a tough adjustment for a young team to have to make. They've been, I think, about as good as they can be against an excellent Wisconsin team.
Now they bring Jackson back out with the three fouls. And we've got 6.5 to go. Kaminsky and Randall right here squaring off. Gosser to Bruss, to Jackson, and 10 to shoot. He's going to drive past Young, and he scores, and he's heading to the line.
That was a great move. Again, that's the beauty of Kaminsky. That pick and roll doesn't allow Randall to guard the basket. And then Trayvon Jackson did a subtle thing there. He just hesitated enough to force James Young to run into him and still had the presence to finish at the basket.
And when you're 8-for-17 from the three-point line and multiple players able to hit from out there, the help is not going to come. Kentucky very wary of those three-point shooters. That's why the Red Sea parted there for Jackson.
We've had two big swings in this half. That incredible run by Kentucky to go 8 up, and now suddenly the Badgers plus 5. It's Randall, and no foul call. Inside 6 minutes.
Wisconsin will continue to move the ball, swing it side to side. If there's nothing there, ultimately, here's a three from Brust. But ultimately, Jackson on the high screen is how they close out possessions.
Poitras. And Brust reached in, snagged the ball, but they say there was contact.
Wow, that was pretty close. I didn't think there was a lot. Let's take a look at that replay here. Wow, that looked about as clean as it could possibly be there on the strip by Brust.
16 foul on the Badgers. Kentucky inbounds underneath. Here's Harrison. Here's Randall on Kaminsky. And the basket counts.
That was just a grown man move.
Yeah, I'll say.
Right there. He just was a little stronger. He got Kaminsky moving, and there's just not much Kaminsky. Had he not come down with his hand there, I don't think there's a foul call, but watch him here. You see that right arm just comes down there, and that's what the official makes the call on.
And it's the third on Kaminsky.
It's amazing. It doesn't matter how many Badgers are in the paint. Kentucky is still going to just put its head down, and go right to the front of the rim and challenge the Badgers at the, on the glass and at the rim.
Three-point play trims it to two. Kaminsky passes up the three, left open, and they're going to count the basket. Goaltending.
There was the execution, and there was Kaminsky again. That curl play and his read with the pop, then the pump fake, and he gets in here, and that ball definitely on the way down. You don't know if it's going to go, but you've taken that opportunity to wait, a way to find out by blocking it and forcing that goaltend call.
Gentlemen, hold on. We've got 5 minutes to go. Andrew Harrison to Poitras.
Oh, my goodness!
He takes it right to him.
Wow.
And draws the foul. On Decker.
Again, nowhere to go for Harrison, but he just wills his way into the paint. And by drawing that attention, there's Poitras waiting. And then he just jumps over the top of Sam Decker.
Those are momentum plays.
Well, Poitras had the momentum plays at about this very juncture in the game against Louisville when there was 4 minutes and a few seconds to go and they were down seven.
You think about this tournament and these two teams in particular, and what separated them is they both owned the last 4 minutes of their game. Let's see tonight who prevails here down the stretch.
Yeah, they both have had big time closes to win the games.
Which was a total change for Kentucky from the regular season. They were 2-8 in games decided by 5 points or less. 3-0 though here in the NCAA tournament. They've grown up and figured out how to win games like these.
Now with 8 to shoot. Jackson, 3-pointer. All Kentucky there for the rebound. Poitras to Young. Coach Cal says put it in the hands of Andrew Harrison.
Well, that was the adjustment, though, that Bo Ryan made in putting Rust on Young. It's allowed Young to be effective, but he's been able to neutralize somewhat both of the Harrison.
And there was a hold on Randall by Brust. Under 4 to go. Who's going to meet UConn Monday night?
Sponsored by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. The Volkswagen TDI Clean Diesel Event. Subway Restaurants. And by AT&T.
Get the most complete coverage of the sports you love all year long with Team Stream app from Bleacher Report. Go deeper with Team Stream on your iPad, iPhone, or Android device today. Kentucky's going to be at the line for a 1-1. It'll be Randall. Guys, talk a little strategy here for each side.
Well, both teams, to their credit, have in essence played the game they won. If you look at Kentucky, they're shooting 51% from the field. You know, they got 11 offensive rebounds. They've dominated plus 22 points in the paint, yet they're down two. I mean, so they can't be demoralized. They just are going to have to win this game down the stretch. And similarly for Wisconsin, Steve.
Well, they're 8-for-19 from three, and that's why this game is where it is. And they've made every free throw, 17-for-17. The question is, can they sustain their effort on the glass? Kentucky, as we've seen throughout this tournament, just overwhelms you. But Wisconsin continues to battle when that ball is loose up on the board.
There's his mother, Carolyn. As Randall ties it with the two free throws. Was looking for Kaminsky. Nothing there. Randall. Got a tight hold on him. Now they got a little mismatch. That's off the foot of Jackson.
Jackson missed his opportunity to get the ball inside to Kaminsky with Randall on him. And that's, as we've talked about throughout the game, when they've gotten him the ball, Kaminsky good things have happened. He's not having a huge night, but it forces the response and the rotations from the Kentucky defense that can trigger a good shot for Wisconsin.
And speaking of turnovers, how about the fact that Kentucky has not committed one in the half, and Wisconsin, one of the best in the country, with five.
Young for the lead. No. And it's Jackson snagging the rebound.
We've got to get the ball to Kaminsky at some point in this possession. Dakari Johnson on the bench. Randall not big enough to handle Kaminsky down there.
You can also get him in pick and roll, though, because it puts Kentucky in a bad position in that situation as well.
There's Kaminsky, and there's another Wisconsin empty trip off a turnover.
He had the angle, just couldn't handle the pass.
Aaron Harrison, who's hit back-to-back game winners, has not attempted a three tonight. His brother lobs it, and Poitras puts Kentucky in front.
How about that catch by Poitras? It was not a good pass. It was a great idea. But this is what athletic ability gives you. It increases your margin of error as Poitras with the putback. Kentucky by two. What a game.
Stay tuned after the game for Inside March Madness, presented by Buick on TBS. How about Poitras again? He gives this team a spark. He was a starter a year ago, and he's had to accept the role as a backup with another incoming group of decorated players. And Poitras has accepted the role. He's a 4.0 student at Kentucky. And in that last rush to break, his coach even gave him a kiss. Look at Coach Cal, come over here. Wisconsin had called the timeout after Poitras took the lob pass to put the Cats up by two, and then right away Kentucky took a timeout of its own.
I think it was because Decker came in for Dukan, and Calipari wanted to make sure the matchups were right.
There's Kaminsky. And again, two on him in a hurry. Decker for the lead back. No. And Poitras able to control it. It's a 9-2 stretch for Kentucky since 67-62 Wisconsin.
And Steve, even though Kaminsky needs to touch it, I think they're more effective, Wisconsin, when he's in pick and roll and in space where Kentucky can't set their defense and their rotations to get to him.
Andrew Harrison, jumper. Gosser has the rebound. No basket from the floor for over 3 minutes for the Badgers. Jackson trying to change that. Got three. Kaminsky with the putback and the tie.
And that was a pick and roll. They switched. Jackson attacks. Now Kaminsky's got Harrison on him, able to win the battle on that offensive glass.
Talk about holding your breath. 1 minute to go. Tied at 71. Randall. Outside, there's Harrison, Andrew Harrison. And Decker off the floor for the Badgers.
Wisconsin perfectly willing to give up that shot. Kentucky just 1 of 4 from the three-point line on the night.
But the key being they've only taken the four, which means they play to their strengths. Now, can they get the stop? And again, I like Kaminsky in that pick and roll, guys.
Inside 30, Jackson with 10 to shoot. Driving in, out to Decker. Wisconsin looking for someone. It's Jackson with two to shoot. Waits, draws the contact, and he'll shoot three.
That's experience against inexperience. Right there. You've won this battle if you're Andrew Harrison and just contest. Instead, he went for the pump fake, and the experience of Jackson to know he had time to wait and accept that contact.
And the ball in the right hands for Wisconsin. Jackson has made so many big shots in his career and so many big free throws in this NCAA tournament. So just the right guy at the line for the Badgers.
He'll be shooting three. And they're just going to double check that. There was 1 second to go on the shot clock.
Now he's clearly behind the line.
Oh, he traveled too.
He did. He got away with one.
He got away with that one.
Jackson for the tournament is 18 out of 20 from the line.
And most of them big ones. You know, I mean, he's the
look at the shot clock here too.
Yeah, I mean, he understood that too. He knew exactly what was on the clock. But Jackson is the heart and soul of this team. He's the one who takes the big shots and makes the plays when they need them.
And not everybody knows, but his dad, Jim Jackson, was a tremendous player at Ohio State, 2-time Big Ten Player of the Year, who saw his career for the Buckeyes end in heartbreak in a regional final in 92 for the right to go to the Final Four, losing in overtime to Michigan. He lost to Jim Jackson in Ohio State in that last game to the Fab Five, the five freshmen. And now his son is trying to knock out the next group of five freshman starters to make it to the Final Four. They came over and confirmed that he was behind the line, so he'll have three chances at the line.
The game clock's going to be set to show 16.4 seconds remaining.
And Dakari Johnson is being brought back off the floor.
Well, he'll be able to sub in after the first free throw. I think because it wasn't a timeout and they were reviewing the play, he wasn't allowed to sub in, but it's a formality. And Dakari will come in after the first free throw.
Oh boy. The first miss of the night by the Badgers.
Not allowing him yet. Remember, there are three free throws.
That's
so
right.
He will come in after the next one.
Wisconsin leads by one.
And that miss is huge because now your strategy completely changes if you're Kentucky. Had he made all three, now you're probably going to have to get a three, which would be out of character for how they played this entire game.
And Wisconsin with the lead now. Well, still.
Whoa. Wow.
The 2-point lead. They've got to contain penetration, but then rebound. They've got to box out and get that loose ball.
Andrew Harrison underneath. Bounce to Dakari Johnson. Back outside. This is the point where he always hits it.
Oh!
Aaron Harrison beyond belief.
And I cannot believe that Wisconsin's best defensive player didn't press up on that play. Watch Josh Gosser here. He's not going to go up. He's basically giving him the 3-point shot there, and Harrison takes advantage.
That's the first three he's taken. And
look how far out he was on that.
But Wisconsin has been so conscious of penetration. Their whole game has been back off and play penetration. Gosser doesn't play the clock here. He backs off just a split second. And that gives Harrison.
Wow.
Oh, can you imagine being his parents?
And that's Aaron Senior. Exactly what he did against Louisville and Michigan. And we had just talked about how he had not attempted one
right
all night long.
If I'm not mistaken, I think Kentucky's made two threes tonight. Their first basket of the game by James Young, and potentially their last one.
That's right.
All right. Wow. Let's figure out the last 5.7 seconds.
One timeout left for Wisconsin. If they want, they can advance the ball into the front court and use another timeout. That way they could set up a play, or they're going to get Trayvon Jackson on a push with the shooter's spread.
And if you're Kentucky, knowing that, you don't want to allow them to roll the ball in. You want to force them to have to catch it as deep in the backcourt as possible and take as much time off the clock as possible before they use that timeout.
Timeout called by Kentucky. And again, Wisconsin's going to have to go the length of the floor.
Timeout, Kentucky. This is a 60-second timeout.
And there's the other thing, too. A lot of times, Steve, we'll take another look at that three-pointer. I mean, I'll tell you what, that was well beyond 24, 25 feet there.
He's much closer to being out of bounds than he was the three-point arc. This is what he did against Louisville. That was with 39 seconds left. What was the game winner? And then a little right of the one he hit tonight, and against Louisville, the one with just outside 2 seconds to go to knock out Michigan in the regional final.
Now, the other thing, as we look at this next play, guys, if you're Wisconsin, you can also look to advance with a baseball pass, because a lot of times the defense is going to push up, trying to not allow you to roll the ball up, and that'll create some space. Now, you're going to have to be a pretty good quarterback.
Yeah.
You're going to have to keep it in front of the safety and over the linebacker, but you can do that, and then you save that time potentially and have a chance to call a timeout.
But a lot of long, athletic defenders for Kentucky. That's a difficult pass. I think ultimately Trayvon Jackson will get the ball.
All right, they back off the inbounds throw. They put five defenders three-quarters court. It's Trayvon Jackson driving in, jumping for the win. No! And Kentucky has done it again. Trayvon Jackson had a shot for the victory.
It's the exact same shot he got to beat Michigan State during the regular season. That one went in significant, but not nearly as such if that one had gone for Wisconsin.
And that literally missed by about an inch. I mean, he's banking this shot all the way, and it's just an inch long. And you see it just rings the rim. I mean, 1 inch, that's the difference between this reaction from Kentucky and what we're seeing from a devastated Wisconsin Badger team.
Just another incredible game. We're going to have two teams play for the championship Monday night. Both of them were not in the tournament field a year ago. A 7 and an 8, the highest combination of seeds to ever make it to Monday night. And let's go over to Tracy.
Thanks a lot, Jim. And Aaron, I have to start with you. 3 games in a row, you hit that shot. How confident are you with the ball in your hands down the stretch like that?
I mean, I'm pretty confident so far. I've been hitting some big shots down the stretch. I didn't play that well today, but I hit a big shot, and I'm happy for my teammates. I'm glad we won.
That's the only one that matters. What can you say about this team and the road you guys have had here and all the struggles you've overcome, and now you're about to play for a national championship on Monday?
Just that we fight so hard, and we're so resilient, and we never stop fighting. And we always thought we were going to win the game, and I think that's why we did it. So.
Thanks so much. And, Coach, let me
– go hug your mom and dad. Go hug them.
And, Coach, let me ask you, you told me at halftime, you told the team that they needed to fight. What about that fight that you saw from the team down the stretch here?
Well, again, we made a bunch of freshman mistakes. I mean, down the stretch, we gave them a chance. We had a 7-point lead, 8-point lead. I thought, okay. And all of a sudden, you look up, it's a tie game. Bo did a great job. Wisconsin did a great job. They weren't going to go away. Whoever had the ball last that could make a shot was going to win the game.
And he's made plenty of them so far this tournament.
That, I mean, Aaron has just done one thing, and he saved his brother. His brother missed the jumper. We wanted him to drive, and he fouls a 3-point shooter. Thank goodness the kid only made two, or this thing's a different ballgame.
Now on to Monday against Connecticut. What about that matchup for a national championship?
Well, first of all, how about the job Kevin Ollie is doing with that program? Incredible, incredible. And I coached him in Philly, so I know him. He is the greatest young man and a terrific coach. He's done great stuff. I don't know anything about them. The issue now, I got to be up all night watching tape, getting ready for them. I know their guards are good, and I know I recruited a bunch of their guys, so I know how good they are, but I don't know how they play.
Well, we wish you the best of luck. We're looking forward to it. Thanks so much. Jim, back to you.
All right. Thank you, Tracy. Every game they've won, all five in the tournament, have been in single digits. And they've been a similar script, although this one's the topper. Aaron Harrison, for the third game in a row. Jackson with the chance, though, to win it. What a night, guys.
Amazing basketball from all four teams, and Kentucky moves on.
Ago with a one-point win for the Kentucky Wildcats over Wisconsin, 74-73. 79,000 plus were here to see it. And most of those folks have stuck around to watch Inside March Madness presented by Buick, and most of them are wearing Kentucky blue. Welcome, everybody. Man, what a night. Ernie Johnson, Clark Kellogg, Kenny the Jet Smith, Charles Barkley. This is awesome. This is awesome.
So it was.
You know, it was a great game. This atmosphere makes it even bigger. You know, I tell people, this to me, I've been blessed to be working with you guys for just our fourth year. There's nothing like this Saturday. And to get a game like that, that's amazing.
Started from the bottom, now they're here.
That's right. That's right.
So you, Drake is in the locker room. But, you know, you see one of the things that those guys were able to do is poise. You know, they held their poise throughout all the adversity that went on through the game. Whenever time you thought that they would go, when Wisconsin would kind of move away from them, Clark, they weren't able to do it. And I think the one thing that, you know, it was funny because it was a tale of two games, because I thought Trayvon Jackson was the MVP of the game if he makes that, before he made that shot, before right. The shot was even taken,
yeah.
And before Harrison makes
the
shot.
Yeah, he had played a beautiful game, running the show.
And when he was out of the game in that early part of the second half, that's when Kentucky made their run. He comes back in, run stops, they go up, and then an unfortunate miss by Jackson.
Yeah, it was a fantastic, fantastic game. And this is the first, Kentucky's the first team, guys, to ever win four straight games by 5 points or less in a single NCAA tournament.
Wow.
That's a mark of poise, shot making. And how about one guy making three game-winning shots in the NCAA tournament? I'm not sure if that's ever been done.
Three-pointers, no less.
That's what I mean. Yeah. It's been phenomenal what these kids have been able to do. And I agree with you guys. The game was played at a really high level.
Yes.
I mean, you look at what Wisconsin did. They did enough to win that game, had a couple of key turnovers late. Trayvon, as great as he played, missed that free throw. But, I mean, it was just a matter of who was going to make another big play, and Aaron Harrison did it for the third game in a row.
Yeah. The bottom line is we know that the matchup for Monday night with the championship on the line, game will be played on CBS. It'll be the 2012 champions, Kentucky, and the 2011 champions, the Huskies of UConn. Monday night on CBS. Let's get to the highlights of this one. Wisconsin and Kentucky. And you got John Calipari in the Final Four for the third time in the last 4 years, and Bo Ryan in the Final Four for the first time. And the number two seed, the Wisconsin Badgers, and this is a great play early.
Trayvon Jackson just deflecting it to his teammate. Koenig is able to get it down. Here you take a look at it again. Nicely done. Good awareness and presence of mind. And right from the start, guys, this game was up and down and played at a really fun pace.
and a high level both ways.
Well, you know, Clark, I told you, here's a transition three that I didn't think that Wisconsin would back down from running. They've been running. That's who they are. They got here by putting up 70, 75 points. Here's a game that goes into those numbers again. And overall, the pace of the game was both ways. Yeah. What's good for both teams.
That's right.
And the one thing that this is where Kentucky is, Randall goes to the basket, and they're able to get offensive rebound after offensive rebound.
At they the same time, Randall gets hurt, though, and goes to the sideline.
He gets hurt, tweaks his ankle, but they have an individual matchup against everyone that they feel that they can beat you off the dribble, every Kentucky player. Here, you have precision and execution on the other end. We say, we're going to get a great shot, Chuck, on every pass and every play run.
You know, you feel for Wisconsin because they did play well enough to win. You know, they just couldn't get that one last shot to go, but this was just a great game. And it really came down to Kentucky killing them on the offensive board. They couldn't keep them out the paint. But this was definitely a flagrant foul. I don't know what people are complaining about.
Well, they called it a technical, dead ball, technical foul.
And yeah, I think they got it right at the end of it. Yeah.
Kaminsky and Dakari Johnson.
No, Chuck, back to your point, even though they got pounded on the offensive glass, points in the paint were even, but Kentucky got 8 more field goal attempts as a result of those second shot opportunities.
Yeah, when you get a chance at 8 more, which is when Kentucky
shoots,
that's 24
points. That's
huge. Yeah, that's 24 points possibilities.
But Julius Randle, how's the ankle?
The thing I was impressed with in this game, I mean, both teams got some knockout punches and got up.
They got
to Kentucky early. They hung in there. They hit Wisconsin with some haymakers, like John said in his interview. When they were up like 8, we're like, oh, this team might get out of hand. Trayvon came in and got the team back under control. Just a great game.
40-36 at the half, Badgers. And then Kentucky comes out full of fire in the second half. This is when they build that lead.
Yeah, when this young team gets rolling, because off the dribble, they're difficult to guard. I would imagine that every guy on their team, when they look at the guy when they catch the ball, says, this guy can't guard me. This guy can't guard me. And so they really don't have to run a lot of sets other than a pick and roll. But then that also gets them in trouble at times too, Clark.
Yeah.
Because sometimes they force shots and don't get those fortunate tippets.
And that was Alex Poitras.
And that's what I want to say something about him, Ernie, because we're going to give Harrison well-deserved credit in both of these games. But Poitras made the plays in the last game and the game tonight to get them in a position to win.
No question.
Yeah.
And so did Marcus Lee. And it's a 15-0 Kentucky run. And you're thinking, uh-oh, Wisconsin on the ropes, and the Badgers come roaring back.
And Dukin had like 8 points in that run that Wisconsin was able to get back into the game. And then good execution here. Trayvon Jackson on a nice cut off the screen at the foul line.
Yeah, their answer was a 15-4 run for Wisconsin.
And here's another look at that play. You take a look at the brush screen. And there's Jackson all alone at the rim. But neither one of these teams backed down or went away. Both of them made big plays and big shots. And as Chuck said, it was just a terrific, terrific game for an opportunity to play on Monday night.
Here's a little more Alex Poitras for you.
Oh, my goodness, right? Oh, give me some of that.
You got some of it. Oh, want to see some more of it?
I tell you what, he
got another look.
Oh. Get off me, little fella.
Hey, that was Forrest there.
That was Forrest.
Yes, sir.
And like I said, he doesn't get the credit for the game-winning shots, but in both of these last couple games, there's another great play by him.
Kentucky on top, 71-69. Are we done? Not even close. Off the Trayvon Jackson miss. Watch Frank Kaminsky. Didn't have a huge game.
Give Kentucky credit for that, though. They doubled him every time he got the ball. But Coach Ryan made a great adjustment, taking it more outside. It was more effective.
He has a veteran play here.
If you mean travel.
Shot clock at 1, too.
Did he travel?
He traveled.
When he draws the foul.
I might have to see that again. I
don't like that call in that situation. That could have been a tough loss.
He hit 2 of the 3 free throws. So it's a 2-point game.
And this is the defensive error.
Are you kidding me? This guy again, Aaron Harrison for 3 for the 3rd straight game.
Because a 3 loses the game. A 2 doesn't do anything but send you to overtime. You have to make a guy drive.
Yeah, but
tough defensive.
You know, you don't think a guy going to shoot a 35 footer.
Man, look, I'm not going to let him try it, though.
Yeah, I know Gosser regrets that he didn't get up into him, just like you said, Kenny.
One more chance. Trayvon Jackson.
Pretty good look. Last shot of the game for a guy who's made winning shots from that same spot on the floor. Got a good look, just didn't get it to knock go down.
Wisconsin that close to moving on to the championship game. Heartache on the Badger side. You saw the celebration, the dog pile on the Kentucky side.
Ernie,
and John Calipari and the Wildcats with the Harrison twins.
He's telling his brother, give him a hug because he saved him.
Yeah, that's what he told Tracy Wolfson after the game.
Yeah.
74-73. I know now why they don't play the championship game on Sunday, because you need to take a deep breath and get ready for Monday night.
And Ernie,
unbelievable
and
stuff.
And some of us have to go to church, too.
I'm looking out for the lightning bolt.
I had totally forgotten about that, Charles. Please pardon me.
Ernest, Sunday's the Lord's day.
Oh, man. Oh, this dude here, man. Why do y'all have me sitting next to him when lightning bolts come? They have no name on them.
74-73.
You're okay, Kenny. Don't worry about it. That lightning bolt
74-73 is the final score. As much as you hear the celebration and the relief maybe from a John Calipari, and there's the Wisconsin side of things. Bo Ryan in his first Final Four, speaking to Tracy Wolfson after the game.
Coach, such a tremendous game, but obviously a hard way to lose. But what can you say about your team's effort today and throughout this tournament?
Well, throughout the season, it isn't just the tournament. It's a culmination of all the work they put in, and they played hard, gave it their best shot. Kentucky was a little stronger, a little tougher inside on the glass. It never comes down to one possession in a basketball game. There's a lot of things that happen out there where we could have maybe changed something, no matter what team comes out on the winning side. So I'm just proud of the way they played, the way they've handled themselves, and the fact that it was right there for them. It's just the other team had one possession better.
You had some time inside with them. What did you say to them?
Well, that's why we're inside with them. Because it's what we say. That's locker room, and that's a bunch of hardworking young men who, you know, understand competition. And unless you've been in that venue and been in that room in that situation, it's hard to tell anybody what you're saying. So we just told them the things that we feel are important, and they understand that.
Tremendous season. Thanks so much, Coach. Appreciate it.
All right, thank you.
So the comeback kids of Kentucky, beat Wichita State to spoil the unbeaten season, down 6 at the half. Beat the reigning champs, Louisville, down 3 at the half. Tied at the half with Michigan, the finalists last year, win that game. And then the number 2 seed, down 4 at the half. And the Cats take it to advance to the championship game on Monday.
I want to give my colleague, Clark Kellogg, some love. He picked Wisconsin to get to the Final Four from the beginning. He deserves accolades for that. You deserve accolades for that.
No, I appreciate that.
I mean, obviously you're a Big Ten guy, but it wasn't a homer pick. They were much better
than a lot of people thought they were.
I mean, I thought they were a good team. They were much better. And when they were doing that piece with Coach Ryan, I took a look at their classes. There's a really good chance they're going to be in the Final Four again next year.
Yeah, they got a number of those guys coming back.
They only losing one guy,
yeah.
Brust.
Yeah.
And Comiskey, he's just a terrific player. They got a terrific coach in Coach Ryan. And Ernie, you asked us earlier today, man, losing just sucks.
The emotion of winning as opposed to the emotion of losing. And that's.
And you know, guys think, like he said, you know, Trace asked him a question like, well, you know, you guys had a great run in the tournament. Them guys been bouncing basketball since last summer. And the finality of losing, first of all, it gets worse the deeper you go. And it's such an awful feeling. But they can be proud of themselves. They represent the state of Wisconsin very well. So I want to acknowledge that. It's a pain that never goes away, but especially when you get this far.
Yeah, I agree. I think the one thing that Wisconsin will have to say to themselves is they've identified themselves with their style of play, what's going to be successful for them in the future, and they know what to work with on the summer. And on the other hand, Kentucky says, yeah, this is our moment. This is our time. We have an opportunity to do something that very few young teams have an opportunity to do. be in a Final Four, and actually now go to a national championship game and win it. The two or three that you can think of on hand would be Kentucky when they had the freshman before, and the famous one of all time, the Fab Five of Michigan. This
would be historic.
Will be historic.
If they get it done.
If they get it done, without question.
And I want to say this one last thing. Well, there's a lot of hate. There's a lot of hate on John Calipari. You know, whether you think of him favorably or not, that guy can flat out coach.
Well, there's no denying that.
And to be able to get these freshmen a couple years ago and come in with five new ones again, they have gotten progressively better. So whatever camp you're in, John Calipari can flat out coach.
And you've got to give those kids an awful lot of credit to the adversity. Kentucky's a very unique place to play because of the scrutiny, the passion, and the expectations. And these kids went through an awful lot of adversity.
Yeah.
They were put on a pedestal before it was earned, and then people were taking shots and pulling them down, and these guys have stayed together. That's a credit to them and to the coaching staff.
Yes.
That these guys have played the way they have and won the way they've had to win. They've had to play championship caliber basketball.
Yeah.
In just about every one of these tournament games.
Oh, no question.
To get to this point, because the other teams had given them an awful lot of resistance.
Without question.
Kentucky takes it 74-73 over Wisconsin. When we come back, we're going to go to Greg Gumbel and his crew. They're going to have the highlights of the night's first game. And all I can say is this. Charles had this one cold. I mean, he could not have been more spot on that first national. So, well, maybe he could have been.
We'll be back.